Welcome back to Let's Play Beyond Skyrim, Bruma. I'm the RPG chick. And I still am outside of White Pine Lodge, like I left last time. But, well, just to be transparent, I did leave and come back. I went back to the Skyrim border gate. Interesting how you can see all this land beyond. But, yeah, I did not, I had to go back to the home, Bree's home, in Whiterun, and well, I had to drop off a bunch of books, so that's that. I don't think I deselected my quest because it was bothering me. So we need to head back to this Sedor, I'm guessing. After spending a night at Bruma's restful watchman tavern, I was approached by a boisterous Nord by the name of Olaf Cold-Heart. Was he boisterous? I don't remember. I agreed to help him rescue a friend. I should meet him at his camp east of the alien ruin of Sedor to begin. He warned me to come ready for a fight. Now, we've been there already, but unfortunately... What can I do? Now we have to go back, so... Well, he doesn't... I'm gonna go from Sedor. So this is gonna be a little different. We snuck our way through there before. But now we're going to... He's probably not going to go into stealth, this guy. They usually don't. These temporary follower types. So it's gonna be complete hack and slash. Okay. I'm like, what the hell is that? The Bunny of Doom! Why do I have two quest markers? Apparently meet Olaf. There's two of him. I don't know. Hey, look at that. Now there's one. The fire was... Oh, he has a few friends.
Hmm? What is it?
I don't know. You tell me.
Hmm?
Hmm?
Can I help you?
Nope.
You made it, friend. Am I glad to see you?
Oh, I didn't even know you were standing there.
Hello? Can I help you?
Tell those guys to shut up. Save it. What's the plan? Yeah, I'm here.
Another moment too soon. My bootstraps are freezing solid.
Oh, you're used to it. You're cold heart.
Now you're here, we are finally at full strength.
Full strength?
And we are going to need all the strength we can get.
All these guys are coming?
The thugs in there are expecting unwelcome guests. It's going to be bloody work. But we'll manage. By the Nine, we are the sons of Skyrim.
Yes, so don't complain about how cold your boots are. What? Who exactly are we saving?
A lad I grew up with. An Imperial courier. Caius. Or at least his documents.
Caius. Oh, no, I'm thinking of Macias. Is that his name? Macias from Falskar? Caius. You don't seem all that concerned about him.
Not all that concerned. I am wearing armor, spilling blood in his name.
No, you just don't sound like it. So who are these people?
Oh, just a few of my other friends. They are going to help us hit those bandits, and hit them hard.
They're probably going to die, some of them.
Don't worry. I trust them with my life.
And so, you guys are the, what, sons of Skyrim?
A slip of the tongue, friend. I'm a proud man. A traditional man.
Okay. Are you a Stormcloak?
No, of course not. No!
You doth protest too much. Come on, tell me the truth.
All right, fine. Yes. I believe that the Stormcloaks are the true sons and daughters of Skyrim.
That's right.
I am doing this to prove my loyalty. And, God, I'm in over my head, aren't I?
This guy's a little crazy. I do sympathize with the Stormcloak, so don't worry.
Good to see your heart in the right place, friend. Let's do this.
Yeah, they were who I took the side of the Stormcloaks in the main quest of the original Skyrim. Yeah, main Skyrim game. Alright, let's get underway then.
By sure, this will be a glorious battle.
It's hilarious.
Come on, everyone. Let's get in there and spill some blood.
I'll try not to kill you guys. Stay out of my way. Yeah, I've been here before, guys. You just follow my lead. Are we going all the way in or just taking care of those bandits? So they're not gonna...
Be more careful.
Can I pickpocket you? They're not gonna... Yeah, sneak.
Don't look at me for directions. I'm not the Whispers Mage.
Was that who gives directions? Whispers Mages?
Alright. I don't know what happens to Caius, but we need to keep our eyes peeled. For him and for his documents.
Okay.
They may be on his person.
They may be. Apparently they're all the way over there. And we are here, alright.
But the bandits may have seized them and scattered them around. Keep your eyes peeled.
Okay. Sounds painful, but sure. I'm sneaking first.
This place feels cold, even to me. And I'm used to good Skyrim weather.
Yeah, you're crazy. They might not have respawned.
These elven... what do they call them? Alien ruins. Mind your step!
Beg your pardon. Were you singing about the alien ruins? Just turning around to look at you, sheesh. I don't think they respawned.
Careful with that fire.
You guys have weapons out. Oh, that's you. They're just completely following me. I thought they'd run ahead. Oh, I didn't see these up here before.
Careful there.
Oh, sheesh, stop. Thank you. I'm stuck.
Mind yourself.
You mind yourself. I'm stuck. The Skyrim Report, Part 2. Where's Part 1? I guess I'll read it. Keep in mind this is Part 2. There's a part before this. Maybe I'll go back and look. They might go in order, I don't know. My own investigations into the character of Ulfric Stormcloak have turned up some very interesting tidbits. We'd been aware for a long time of his status as a potential asset of the Thalmor, but if he ever operated in their interests, one thing is clear. The Thalmor have utterly lost control of him. This uprising has grown beyond mere agitation and distraction from the Empire's southern borders and into the realms of true full-scale secession. Elven soldiers and agents rarely make it out of Stormcloak-held territory in anything approaching one piece, and as far as I can tell, the leadership of the natives has refuted all direct communication with the Thalmor or their embassy. This is not to say they aren't receiving any outside support. I provided an attached list of 14 companies and organizations I suspect of providing arms, armor, or funds to the Stormcloaks, many of which are registered under Altmer and Imperial names. Ulfric appears to have purged himself and his organization of the most overt elven influences some time ago. Whatever he was fighting for in the end, he bloody meant it. Yeah, it was some kind of... I never knew if this was actually true. His asset of the Thalmor. Apparently an unwitting asset? Like he didn't know he was working for them or something? What? Not that he was working for them. So we have found a page here, but our destination's here. So I want to see if there's
what
any
is
more.
It?
It's a note. It's a rabbit haunch. Let me go back and see if there's anything, any letters. I wasn't really looking that carefully. This is a pretty nice bedroll, let me tell you. Oh god, you guys are... There's too many of you. Yeah, I'm gonna sheathe this, I'm not sure.
Feeling clumsy today?
I'm putting away my sword. You mind? I can't do that? Here. Here's part one. For the inward-seeing eye in Cyrodiil's nobody, only Skyrim report. What does that mean? Inspector Claudius, 16th Last Seed, 4th Era 201. Hail! I hope this report receives you in good health. The Divines, you're going to be feeling good when you finish reading it. Am I? As I'm sure you're aware, I was assigned to the Skyrim task as a personal attaché of General Tullius and to monitor the increasingly warm Cold War between the Empire and the Dominion. The situation is getting, well, warm, especially after Ambassador Elenwen's own reassignment to the North following the Markarth incident. I'm going to assume you're familiar with the official version of the Civil War in Skyrim. I understand the Nibbin Herald can't get enough of it. But events up here have finally taken a positive turn. General Tullius has, just hours before these documents were drafted, captured the Bear of the North himself. We suspect Ulfric Stormcloak and a cadre of supporters were trying to sway the Orphan Rock clan of witches in Falkreath into treason against the Empire when they were tempted by a bait force of legionnaires. The Orphan Rock witches. I remember Orphan Rock. To their great credit, the men were able to draw the Stormcloaks close enough to the border with Cyrodiil to allow a much larger force to incapacitate the traitor and his men. They are now being escorted under heavy guard to Helgen, an Imperial stronghold in the area. And we know what happened then, because that's where Skyrim, the game, begins. Being escorted to Helgen. That's the end of that note.
Don't look at me for directions. I'm not the Whispers Mage.
Alright, well I got the second page. They're a little slow. Ah. Okay, that's where I found the note just now. Oh, I can take these. Welkin stone. We've seen what these do. It completely... Your magic, I make sure... Magic come back or something? I don't know why I can't talk. Welkin Stone. Fully recharge your mana magicka reserves. I didn't realize you can take them. And they weigh nothing. It's awesome. Oh, we're going here into the maw? Wait. No. Not this way, at least not yet. Oh, here's another one. Oh, I can't grab that one. That one's not real. Okay. I couldn't even see anything. Apparently he's right over there. Contacts and roots. Oh, that's definitely him. Stormcloak activity heavy near Pale Pass. May seek to intercept documents. Avoid at all costs. Oculatus agent lying low in a Bruma cavern. Apparently the shadier one. Best check restful watchman to make delivery. Avoid Thalmor agents if at all possible. Could intercept. May lead... ...complications. Oculatus agent in a Bruma cavern. The Bruma caverns that we've been to already? That's the end of that. Okay, there's no more pages.
Dumbledore! His documents aren't here.
I have them.
I doubt they have gone walkabout. They should still be here in this blasted ruin. Somewhere. We'd best keep our eyes peeled. Maybe retrace our steps.
Hey, watch it!
Oh, stop. List of Stormcloak sympathizers. Okay, I didn't realize what I was looking at. Is this a scroll, or what is this? Where is it? Oh. I cannot equip this item. This is a list, but I can't read it.
His document should be here. Somewhere.
Oh, there's more? More documents? Okay. The water cushioned my fall. So funny. Oh. The things that were here already destroyed and didn't respawn. The Skyrim Report Part 4. Part 3. I feel it is inevitable that Ellen Wen will try some last-minute, desperate attempt to keep Ulfric alive and this war going. Can't believe I missed two more. As of writing this report, she has unsuccessfully attempted to take command of the prisoner detail herself and has demanded to speak to Tullius again upon their arrival at Helgen. Of course, after passing into Thalmor hands, the Stormcloaks will make a miraculous, quote-unquote, escape attempt, and the war will rage on. Tullius, for his part, has treated any threats, diplomatic or otherwise, with all the contempt they deserve. Elenwyn. Mm. Two seemingly unaffiliated individuals were caught in the ambush and interred with the rebels, a horse thief and a traveler from over the border. Hey, that's me. They are being treated as potential inside agents or jailbreakers. And the horse thief... I remember him. He was the one who shot down with the arrow. They are being treated as potential inside agents as or jailbreakers. After all, the timing of their arrival is a little too convenient for anyone's taste. And this time, the general is determined not to take any chances. Yeah, it was just our bad luck. Where's that guy from again? I can't remember. In the wagon, we had asked him where he was from, and we ended up visiting that place later. It's not much to speak of course. It's like this little farm with like two or three houses. I can't remember the name of it. It's gonna come to me anytime though. It's Is it Iverstead? Oh, Rorikstead. He's from Rorikstead. Which is also the mentioned in the Ragnar the Red song. Okay. Let me take a look at the second one again. What is it called again? Is it Skyrim something? I don't even remember. The Skyrim Report. The Skyrim Report. Okay, so this is part one. Alright, and then two. Potential asset of the Thalmor. If he ever operated in their interests, they lost control of him. That's if he ever did. So they're trying to manipulate him or use him as a chess piece or something. This uprising has gone beyond mere agitation, blah blah blah. That's the list they mentioned. An attached list of 14 companies and organizations I suspect of providing arms, armor, or funds to the Stormcloaks. Many of which are registered under Altmer and Imperial names. Okay. And then he's thinking that Elenwen will try a last-minute desperate attempt. And he mentions me and the guy was shot down. You don't tell her it's not going to take any chances. It's going to kill everybody. Which brings me to our last point, the summary execution of Ulfric Stormcloak, his supporters, and any suspected enemy agents upon their escort to Helgen. No trials, no protests, no escape. Yeah, that seemed that was kind of, like, crazy. They just caught me nearby, and so, yep, we're gonna chop her head off. Short, yes. Brutal, absolutely. Illegal, quite possibly. I don't doubt it. Actually, now that I think of it, doesn't seem legal, but yet all these people were involved. Only the witnesses. I guess they were, completely, loyal to Tullius, anyway. Frankly, we just want this damn war over. The men of the 4th Legion want to go home. Every minute Ulfric stays alive not only prolongs the bloodshed, it strengthens the Thalmor and makes it more likely Elenwen, the horse thief, or the Traveler will enact an escape plan. Yeah, we had good luck there, I think. I mean, at least I don't think Alduin had anything to do with it. You never know. More time means more dead men, women, and children. I feel it is everyone's best interest that every prisoner captured meets their end at Helgen to avoid a long, protracted war. I am willing to personally vouch for Tullius if you feel this is beyond his remit to end the uprising. I will be sending this message with a messenger of the general while I accompany him to Helgen to see the end of all this. You'll find the Bear of the North's Head following a few days later with my full report. I look forward to my debriefing back home. Long live the Emperor, Agent Claudius. Which I guess is Caius.
All right, friend. We've got what we came for. Oh. We'd best get out of here. I don't like these ruins. And there may be more bandits returning from the wild soon.
I already killed them all.
We got what we were looking for. Let's get out of here.
Let's get out of here. Okay. Well, that was easy. Didn't have to do nothing. Wander around and look for letters.
Thought you could get away, huh?
Ah! It's you, Precious the Pillager! Ah! Found it, outlaw!
What's going on here?
That was a weird sound. You take care of them. They spawn right by the entrance.
Careful with that fire.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to hurt anybody, like bandits or something. Where'd the other body go? Oh.
Come, taste darkness's embrace.
Oh, Precious the Pillager didn't have much on him. Guy's having trouble or something.
Glorious body.
Hello.
Glorious battle. Cool, elven arrows. I need those. Don't need steel, that's for sure. Yeah, I don't have much of stuff here. Alright. Well, I have the greater soul gem.
Is it?
What is it?
Hello? Hello?
We got what we were looking for. Let's get out of here.
Okay, back to getting out of here. The guy's waiting outside or what?
We did it! By the divines, we did it! That was glorious.
No, like a few
and
of them.
It's all thanks to you, my friend. You certainly have a knack for dealing with bandit scum.
I didn't do much.
And you have even recovered Caius's last delivery.
Mm-hmm.
He was a good friend. For an Imperial. He deserved a fate better than this.
Yeah, the ad at the end, though.
But even this is better than his reports finding their way back to the Imperials.
Yeah.
Hand them over. I'll give you your gold. And then join my brothers and sisters up north.
Is there a reason for me to even keep these documents? I'm kind of curious. I would normally just give them to him, but... Nah, I'm not gonna give you the documents.
What? Why not? They are nothing to you. I won't ask again. Give me the documents, or I'll take them from you.
Oh my. Don't threaten me again, friend. Leave, and never return.
Fine. Fine. Just don't hurt me.
Burn the documents at a bonfire in Bruma. Is this guy running back all the way back to Bruma?
Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
Oh. What is it?
It's me. Gonna kick your butt. All right. Yeah, I'm gonna burn him in a bonfire? Alright. It's in Bruma? It's just weird. Don't ask me, guys, why I actually didn't give it to him. I just wanted to see what would happen. Am I heading towards the bonfire? Wait. Where am I? Oh, the Imperial agent is there. Where am I? Oh. Bonfire. In here? Where'd the bonfire go? This bonfire?
Suckered by the Synod. Weary of the whispers.
What is it?
It's a, looking for a bonfire, hello? Apparently. Hello. See, I see that. What bonfire? Oh, now it shows up again. It's just past White Pine Lodge. Get along, you two. Is this the bonfire? Alright. Wait, what about... Oh, part four. Okay. Like, what happened to part four? Wow, there's nothing. I have no quests. That's crazy.
Zombies tend to haunt caves. Be careful if you decide to go treasure hunting.
I have no quests. I have nothing. Alright guys, thanks so much for watching. Still gonna explore, of course. We got more places that we haven't seen. We have this plundered mine that someone told us about at some point, so it got marked on our map, but no quest associated with it. And we have some places over here, and I think we got some stuff up here somewhere to take care of. There's bound to be plenty more. So thanks so much for watching. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.